People say we can't do it, that it will not work. We can do it, and it will work, and we're determined to make it work. To help us in doing this, we're also going to learn from the experience of another country similar to ours, which was at about the same state of economic development in the 60s as Nigeria.
Once we agreed upon the six sectors, for example, here, in the case of Malaysia, the step two, we have lab. This is a new language I'm going to introduce to you. Lab is to get some of your best and brightest people in those economic sectors, say agriculture, you put civil servants for agriculture, plus private sector in the room, plus all the experts inside the room. In the case of Malaysia, 8 weeks, sometimes 6 to 8 weeks, full time. Everybody is seated in the room full time to figure out what to do with agriculture in detail, not at 30,000 feet, in detail. And the motto of the lab is this: we do the analysis, problem solving, solutioning, budget, very detailed. The motto of the lab, Hotel California. Some of you know the song Hotel California, the Eagles. You can check out anytime you like, but you can never leave. That is what you do in the lab.
Challenge is the discipline to be unreasonable in our targets and objectives, and the discipline of attending, in my own opinion, those labs diligently and accepting to be locked in the room for as long as it takes to iron out whatever we need to do. I like the point also that Dr. Jala made, that the excuse that it won't work here, that, you know, sometimes what we describe as the Nigerian factor, or some say exceptionalism, and acceptance of failure people before we even start, is certainly not tenable anymore. We simply have to accept that there is nothing Nigerian about failure. Because as we know in our personal lives, failure and success are commodities on offer to everyone all over the world. And every individual and every country makes a choice which to buy. I would want to say on our behalf that we will choose success. Dr. Jala, I've heard many motivational speeches. As a matter of fact, I'm a pastor, so I've made some myself. But this is one I think challenges our whole legitimacy as persons entrusted with leadership. I think it goes beyond the motivational speech. I think it really challenges us at the core of our relevance as leaders. You know, and I'm challenged, I know that many of us here are, and I think that we will do what we need to do to make sure that we see through the labs. We're going to have to identify specific areas where we'll do these labs. We must see to it that this works. I want to thank you again very much for this very, very exceptional morning that you've taken us through. And to thank all of you also for making the time to come. So the work has just begun. Thank you.